Good morning. Welcome to the VCLO Roundtable. Today, it's going to be a little bit run by the ladies. So if you don't know me, my name's Misty. We have Imelda Medina.
Hi.
Pastor Medina's wife with us
today.
Good
morning.
We also have Sister Anna Bradford, Brother Larry, Pastor Larry's wife. And then we have Mercedes Brown. Mercedes is our children's director here at VCLO.
Good morning.
So welcome, and today, let's see what the ladies have in store. Who has something they'd like to share?
Well, I like to share, the Lord had given me two songs, and I mean, it's like Psalms 35, what it talks about, weeping may endure for the night, but joy will come in the morning. So I mean, that really, you know, there's a message there, you know. I know there's a lot of people that are probably weeping, but it talks in the word that I mean, it would come where, you know, you will get that the joy of God, you know, it would come. And it could be this morning, we never know, it could be this morning. And there's also another one that really cut to me, and it's Psalms 126:5. And it talks about they who sow in tears shall reap in joy and singing. So I mean, that really, you know, those two songs really, you know, just God gave me to share this, you know, this morning. So that's what I had this morning, and I pray that I would touch somebody this morning, that there is hope in Jesus. Mm-hmm. There's hope in God.
Yeah.
And there's nothing that he doesn't know, and there's nothing impossible for him. Because all things are possible through him, and that's in Luke 18:27. You know, so that's what I had. To just build you up, that there's nothing impossible for the Lord.
So, you know, that's a great scripture for weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning.
Amen. Amen.
So, when we talk about that, when the Bible talks about that, do we think that night is a time? Like what we think of as night? Or do we think of that as a season or a feeling?
I think it's seasonal, because it could take, you know, God knows when, you know, he's ready for your miracle, and but we can't give up. We can't give up on praying, and, you know, because it'll be, you know, God knows the timing.
You know, and that struck me. You had shared that scripture with me earlier, but now when it says, you know, the darkness may come in the night, but joy comes in the morning. A lot of times when we're in a situation, doesn't it feel like it gets to a point where we went through the day, we've lived through this situation, we've faced this consequence,
yeah.
And usually at night is almost what symbolizes the end of the situation,
mm-hmm.
when it gets dark,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
when you're starting to be on the edge of hope, or losing hope. So joy comes in the morning. So
amen.
Maybe it's just lasting through that darkness.
Yes, amen, amen, amen.
That was good. Thank you.
Yes. You're welcome.
What other thoughts are we meditating on today, ladies?
God's really been putting on my heart our purpose and his presence, focusing in on his, honing in on his presence, because sometimes I hear it all the often, God doesn't talk to me, or I don't hear God, or I just don't know why he's not answering, or he's not talking back to me. And so Matthew 28:20, where it says, teach these new disciples to obey all commands I have given you. And be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age.
Amen.
Kind of just, again, knowing that he's with us no matter what, even if we don't feel him or see him, he knows everything. He knows all that's going on. Just to not rely on our own understanding.
Yeah, His grace is sufficient for us. You know, there's a scripture of His grace is sufficient on Corinthians 2:12-9, that His grace is sufficient for us.
Mm-hmm. One of my favorite scriptures is Lamentations, and it kind of works in with this, Lamentations 3:21, a few verses down, and then it says, "This I call to my mind, therefore have I hope. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because His compassions fail not."
Amen. He's a compassion God.
"They are new every morning. Great is Thy faithfulness."
Amen.
"The Lord is my portion, saith my soul, therefore will I hope in Him. The Lord is good unto them that wait for Him, to the soul that seeks Him."
Amen. That's a beautiful scripture.
So that kind of ties in with your scriptures about, you know, that. And we can know that the compassions of the Lord never fail. He wants what's good for us always.
Amen.
And if we seek Him, He will always make a way where there seems to be no way. Even in the dark of night, when we're just in that place where we're just, it doesn't seem like we're getting anywhere, that thing is just heavy, God will make a way.
Yes, He will.
Yes.
His promises are real.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Now, there's times in our lives where we don't see the end of the situation,
right?
And for anybody listening, if you're not familiar, we've been having a women's Bible study at the Brown House. And there's a lot of gems that have been pulled out of this, a lot of wealth, just from a few scriptures, you know, the story of Deborah. And, you know, we had talked about mercy. And as a woman, we want to listen with mercy and grace.
Amen.
And so many times it's easy to instead look at things with a negative attitude. And to not recognize the grace of God and the mercy of God in the situations. So learning as a woman, or as anybody, a woman, a man, a child, to dwell on the positivity and the mercy and the hope that God is faithful.
Yes, He is.
He is faithful.
Yes, He is. He's faithful.
And when we're in that night, there's a morning coming.
Amen. Amen.
And we've got to seek and hear His face.
Amen.
Or seek His face and hear His voice. Hear His presence.
Amen.
Just that scripture that I had read about that, His compassions fail not.
Oh,
that
they're
new every morning.
Every morning they're new.
So you can't feel like, oh God, I know I've come to You with this problem time and time and time again. But the scripture tells us that His compassions fail not, and they are new. His mercies are new every morning. Every morning. It's a new day. It's a new day, and we can look and hope and rejoice in the fact that God sees us, He knows us, and
He
is there for us every day. Every day. It's a new day, and we just have to know that God loves us so much that His compassions never fail.
Mm-hmm.
Never
Amen.
Fail. But we have to make room for Him, like the song says.
Yes.
You know, I will make room for You.
Yes, God is so good. He's good to us.
Does anybody have a story of God's goodness that they'd like to share?
Oh, yes, I have. I have stories. I mean, yes, I think God is just so good. I mean, He had pulled my... I mean, He had done so many things in my life. I brought my husband, to be a preacher. you know, through my, through, I mean, there's nothing impossible for the Lord. I mean, the praying and, I mean, bringing him up, I mean, from a drug dealer to a pastor now, and, you know, an evangelist. Yes. And then my son being a youth pastor. Yeah. And I'm like, God, I know that he has something more in my family. I'm still waiting for more. And I believe that there's more, you know. I believe my grandkids will be in the pulpit too, you know, and preaching the word. And I know that there's going to be a day where I get to see that too. You know, he's so good to us. And I mean, he's been good to me.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So many times lately we've talked about, and I say we, meaning different people. Mm-hmm. And we read these books in the Bible, and some of my favorite stories are involving the women of the Bible. Mm-hmm. Deborah.
Yes.
And Esther. Esther's one of my favorite stories. Mm-hmm. And then there's Ruth and Naomi, and then there's, yes, Lois and Eunice, yes, raising Timothy. And some of these stories are only a chapter or two long. Some are a little longer. But what's amazing is, take, for example, step back from your life and look at it. Look where you started.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And look where God stepped in.
Oh, yes. Yes, he's so wonderful.
And then you got to realize where God stepped in, but you weren't realizing that he was stepping in at the moment. And then go to this point and realize that your story's not done. Mm-hmm. But what's been written so far is just amazing. Absolutely amazing. So when you see these stories and you read them, realize that these are the stories that have been shared with you, but God's writing your story too.
Amen. That's what, amen, I was saying. Like, I was thinking about that, you know. Like, oh, you, yeah, mentioned some ladies' names, you know, and there's like Misty and then Mercedes, mm-hmm, and Sister Anna, you know, and of course, you know, me. And I mean, we're like, we could write our names like that too. And there's more. I know there's more.
Yeah, we just have to be willing vessels.
Amen. Amen. We have to be willing.
Uh-huh. To be obedient. Amen. To whatever,
amen,
the Lord is leading in our lives and speaking to our hearts.
Yes, willing to accept it and not fight it or have that doubt. You know, women, they are very... we like to critique ourselves, or, oh, I can't do that, or I'm not good enough. And that's one of the things Misty mentioned, uh-huh, in the Bible study, that our first lesson was, you're not just this person. You're much more than that.
And, amen. Amen.
God has a plan, and he wrote our life already, and he knows he has his plan, and we just have to be willing to,
amen,
do his work and not fight it, even if it brings you out of your comfort. And that's okay.
Amen.
It's okay to continue to grow.
Yeah. The Lord will give you wisdom, I believe. You know, there's a scripture for that. It's on Corinthians 1:30. That way he will give us his wisdom.
And God's plans for us are good.
Yes.
He doesn't bring us to a place of destruction.
Mm-mm.
His plans are always good, and we have, amen, to remember that too, that what he wants for us is the best.
Amen. Amen.
We can try to work out our own will and way, but you know, we have to know that God has to be in control.
Amen.
Because he will do far better for us than we,
amen,
can ever imagine.
Amen.
And he is there to help us through every situation.
Amen.
Meet every need.
Yes.
But we have to trust him and just put our lives in his hands to know that his plans are good.
Amen.
Good plans.
Amen.
Very good plans. Imelda and I were talking earlier. We had read Ephesians 3:20. Now all glory to God, who is able through his mighty power at work within us to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask or think.
Yes.
So does that mean that we're going to be able to walk into any situation that we desire, and because the Lord's on our side, we're going to be able to do it? Not necessarily.
Right.
That's right.
Because we are still needing to be in His will. We're needing to follow His plan for our life. So if we're moved to go start a certain movement or to do something, and God's like, I have everything aligned for you to go and do this. This is what I want you to do. And I'm over here, Imelda, no, we're going to start a crochet class. And God's like, no, I want you to go over here and start this. And we're praying, and we're like, Lord, this crochet class, everything keeps coming unraveled. What's going on? I thought you would help me crochet. I've never done it before, but I thought that these ladies would, you know, I think that this is a great. And He's just like, oh, I've got a perfect way. You just need to follow me. You need to listen to me.
Amen.
Because there is something over here that's far greater than what you
yes,
for yourself.
Yes, I believe that His ways are greater. I believe that, too.
And He is able to do. But we like to stub our own toes sometimes. We like to hinder things.
God knows the beginning to the end. Amen. And all we see right now is the here and now.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
And God knows all of it.
Amen.
And so we just see the little pieces of the puzzle, but He sees it all together.
Oh, yes. Yes. Yes,
and
He does.
Knows that His way is the best way, and we just have to get on board with that.
Yeah. And how nice is it when we are flowing with that?
Amen.
Yes. That's just amazing. Well, does anybody else have some final words you'd like to share today?
Any of the ladies?
All right. Well, I think that this has been a little bit of a short roundtable, but it's a little different roundtable.
Yes.
We've shared, you know, our hearts and,
yes,
and some things going on. So before we sign out, Imelda, would you say a prayer over our services and over our fellowship today?
Yes, Father God, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father God, Lord God. You are so good, Father God. Pray, Father God, for the service this morning, Lord God. That, Father God, your Holy Spirit move, Father God, in this sanctuary, Father God. Thank you, Father God, that you've been with us, Lord God. We love you, Father God, and bless the hearers, Father God, this morning, Lord God. Father God, it's all about you. And I pray, Father God, for your peace, Father God, for the peace of people, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Your peace to flow, Father God, in the hearers, Father God. Thank you, in Jesus' name, amen.